shared dice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 18 in our series nerddice.com, where we build a Ruby on Rails 7 application that allows for tabletop role-playing game management. We haven't done any features associated with the actual role-playing stuff yet. We've done some setup, and now we're working on user authentication using Devise. We've been working on this for several videos now, and our task list has had babies since the last video. So some of these other first couple of videos where we went through some of these tests went really long. So I broke these things out into smaller parts. So user can reset password is different than user can change password. And there were a couple other scenarios that we hadn't accounted for yet. So I updated the task list. So in this episode, we're going to deal with writing browser system tests for the scenario to ensure that the user can reset the password if they've forgotten it. So that's what we're going to be working on, and we'll get started. There is a duplicate word there. Just fix that on the fly. So here is, we're going to demonstrate the item that we're going to be changing here. Let me fire up server. And we will go to, this is the users can change password. We want to get back to users can, wait, does that actually say localhost foo? I need to find a user first. I might have gotten rid of all of them. Let me fire up the terminal here. Rails console. All right, testing 2 at example.com. We've signed in, now back, user sign in, already signed in, all right, so we're signed out here. Sign up. Log in. So this is the scenario that we're testing here. Forgot your password. So we're going to click on the, going to visit the password new page. We're going to use this testing 2 at example.com. And we're going to hit the send me reset password instructions. Now it says you will receive an email with instructions on how to reset your password in a few minutes. That email should have been sent here. and the link here, passwords edit, and then the reset password token. So this should, shut down my server, hit Control C instead of Control Shift C to copy here. So I should be able to do this now, and now I'll have a new new password. And we've got success. So that's the test we are going to be creating. We're going to go into VS Code and into our Devise tests here. So this is going to be similar to the reset password test. We'll rename the class. And then we'll keep the I will pause the video and write our kind of take the first pass at writing these tests, and then I'll unpause and then we'll talk through it. All right, so I've got right now I'm not doing anything with the reset password itself, but I'm going to go over the method standard reset password preconditions that I'm going to call from each of these other methods. I have the other methods set to skip so that they we don't kind of false positively forget about them and have them show as passing when they're skipped. So what we're going to do is just like we did in the browser here, go to the welcome URL, click on login, forgot your password, and then make assertions about the state of that page. That's as far as we've gotten so far. And then we will run that test. So Rails test. Reset. Got the 9 assertions, so we're doing good so far. I'll pause and write the implement the first method now. All right, so I think I've got this method implemented here. So we are going to fill in the email with our user's email, click on send password, reset instructions, assert the flash text there, like we did and when we showed this, reload the user. So I did add in an item to the standard preconditions to assert that the user's reset password token is nil. And then after that, we're going to reload that user, assert that that password token is no longer nil. And then we're going to visit the new user password URL, which I figured out by going here to, let's say, so it was user's password new here. So if you need to find out what the helper is for that, you can just throw in a bad URL here and then user's password new. So new user password path is what we had there, our new user password URL as we do in our, let me make this a little bigger, in our system tests here. So we visit that with our password token. I added another helper method for just asserting the change password page assertions when you visit there. And then on that page, let's go in and take a look at it. So we'll log this user out. Go back to login, forgot password. So these are the pages here, the assertions here we're making about the page. We click on send reset password instructions. We get our password token here. And this is the page that we're making those assertions about. So change your password and everything. And then we're filling in the new password and the confirm new password fields with our new password, which we set here as an instance variable so that we can reuse our happy path password in more than one place. And then after we do that, it will say your password has been changed successfully. You are now signed in. So, and then we make the welcome page logged in assertions that we have in our system test case there. So let's see if this works. Oh, we've got a failure here. So, didn't find checks text change your password on line 68. Change password page assertions. Oh, that's, hold on here. All right, so we've got, let's just comment this out for a second here. That failed as well. So let's, this is the change password page. So maybe we're not getting to that point there. So let's go back to this here. Rerun this. Take a look at our screenshot. This is, these show up in the temp folder of your project. And then if you go to screenshots, send me reset password instructions. Did I not click on that? So let's see what line we got to here. Line 68 from line 14. Click on forgot your password. Let me see. We're going to throw in a debugger statement here. I think it makes it to this point. And we'll run this with so we make it to that point, and then we're attempting to visit. Maybe my parameter is wrong there. It's got a token, and then I'm visiting the new user password URL with a let's see what happens here when I got the password token here. Receive a password. Maybe it's the edit path. No. All right, we'll fail this and so, visit new user password URL. Let's make sure I'm doing this correctly. It's user's password edit. That's the problem. And then try edit user password URL. We'll just here. Didn't take out the debugger statement. Try it again. Reset password token is invalid. Reset password token is invalid. I wonder if it's not actually the token that gets sent in the email. Let's investigate. So we're going to go and take a look at the Devise emails here. Use Devise mailer reset password instructions. So it's the edit password URL with the resource, and the token is at token. Let's see what that value gets set to. Buys mailers, helpers, I'll take a minute and research this. All right, I've solved the problem. So it's, you can see here, the edit password URL button link here takes the resource as the first argument there. So that's the problem, that we didn't have that in our previous setup, because there wasn't a user when we did the email confirmation. So let's give it another shot. Still saying the token is invalid. Edit password URL for the user. Made it to that point. it's saying that. Throw in a debugger there. Try it again. Got the user password token. User's password edit dot. Why is it dot rather than slash? I guess let's take a look at how it looks in the edit. You set password token. Edit password URL. At resource, which is what we got. Edit password URL. Try it again. Rid of the debugger. Gotta pay attention that you're going to the right URL. Okay. Undefined method. Edit password URL. Okay, so that's doing something. Okay, let's go back to user password URL. Guess we can. That in a put statement and see what it gives us. Compare that to our email. Right. So that's users slash password slash edit. And we've got users slash password slash edit. reset password token. That's a much shorter token. Go and forget our user again. Login, forgot password. Got my password. All right. So the email has been sent. Our reset password token is this string here. Password token is nil. Make sure testing at example, we're doing testing two. Reset password token is different than the string that we are getting in our email. That string is completely different than confirmation token, reset password token. Okay, so how do I get that maybe I need to do puts for that URL. That URL might be different because of the so let's try that puts. We'll do the one that's in the email there. Back. try it again. No method, edit password URL. Maybe it's in the mailer helper. Device mail, device mapping. Edit password URL. It's in the vise, it's in the templates. That token. There's a method being called in the mailer that is not matching what I would expect. Pause and do some more research. All right, I think I'm on to something. So if we go into the console here, devise, so this is the string here is the thing I got from my email. And if I do my user.resetPassword token, that's the value there. And then if I send in that string to devise token generator.digest, I get that value back. So we're not actually sending the password regeneration token in the email. We're sending kind of the token gets made into a digest, and that kind of encrypted digest is what we've got in our saved in our database. So back in our tests here, you can use the debugger here. And we've got the action mailer base deliveries, and we can get the last body dot raw source, and that gives us a string. And then I'm going to use a tool that comes in very handy from time to time, Rubular. So this is our test string, and we are wanting to match this. So we are going to look at this is going to be interpolated when we actually do this, but all these forward slashes need to be escaped. Also, character actually, I can probably just do the reset password token equals. And this is going to be my guess is W plus backslash backslash quote. So see if that will work as our regular expression here. Method here. Maybe we've got new lines here. So that's an I. Make dot match new lines. All right. So this is saying that I'm matching. That is saying I'm not. So that gives us the match data, and then that gives us exactly what we need. That match data. Here are our methods here. Not a dot string. string that we're matching. String. All right. So let's see if we can. Just do token equals and then this. See if that gets us to a pass. Oh, come on. Reset password token is invalid. It's possible that I just messed that up. All right, I think I got the, sometimes these tokens have hyphens in them, so that was causing the intermittent failure. So sometimes it was passing, sometimes it was not. So we'll replace the slash W with this. Run our test. A few times to get some variety here. There's that hyphen. That's our test case that was failing before. Satisfied that that is passing consistently now. And I think we'll stop there and pick up the kind of unhappy path stuff in the next video, because this was a lot more trouble than I anticipated. So we'll stop there. We won't commit the code here. We'll just pick up where we left off. Thanks for watching this stateless codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.